class. I hope you all are safe at your home, right? Okay, today we will proceed our chapter number 2, where we had discussed in our previous lecture about the mixture, about the like compounds, the elements and the atom, right? All these terms we had discussed in our previous lecture. We had discussed about the mixture. What is the meaning of mixture? These are the composition of two compounds where they may be in homogeneous, they can be easily separated by the physical, they are not combined with the physical bonding, chemical bonding, simply you can say that. But physically they are mixed, that is called the mixture. And they are of two types, heterogeneous and homogeneous. In homogeneous, we cannot separate out the two mixture from one another without any physical activity. But in the heterogeneous mixture, we can easily visualize the two different layer of the mixture which are mixed with each other. So on the basis of this, we have some few terms are also remaining on the basis of mixture. First is a solution. What is the meaning of solution actually? Solution is a homogeneous mixture always. It is not a heterogeneous mixture. It means it is a homogeneous means where the boundaries of two mixture cannot be visible. You can say that they are mixed into each other very sharply. We cannot visualize the two different mixture. In case of solution is generally made up of the two compounds. The solute, it is a solid substance, and the solvent, it is always a liquid which is we will use. So it is a homogeneous mixture where the two mixtures are mixed to each other very completely, you can say that. So we cannot differentiate two type of mixture in that kind of mixture, in homogeneous mixture, which is called the solution. If we will discuss about the type of solution, we have three type of solution obviously: the solid type of, the liquid type gaseous type of solution. If we will discuss about the solid type of solution, it means where the solute particles are more as compared to the solvent. In liquid, solvent is more, that's why it is liquid in form. And in gaseous, where in this kind of mixture there are gaseous particles are more as compared to another particles. For example, for the gaseous particle, the mixture of air consists various type of gases. These are also a mixture of homogeneous gases, so it is a solution, gaseous solution. If we will discuss about the liquid solution, for example, you mix a sugar or salt molecule into the water molecule, it becomes a solution, it forms a solution which is liquid in nature. This solution is called the liquid solution. Next is our solid solution. For example, the mixture of iodine and alcohol, it is called the tincture of iodine. Here the iodine is a solid and the alcohol is liquid, but solid is more visible as compared to the liquid, so that kind of solution we call the solid solution. So on the basis of their variety, they are of three main types: the solid, liquid and the gaseous type of solution, right? On the basis of their concentration, simply you can see that. Now next is the, what is the property of the solution? If there is any solution, how can you find out this is a solution? Firstly, the solution will always be a homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture in which we cannot separate out the two mixtures compound. You cannot be separate out. That kind of mixture is called a homogeneous. So first property is that about the solution, they are always homogeneous in nature. Next, the particle of the solution are always smaller than the 1 nanometer, right? That's why we cannot separate these solution particle with the help of the process filtration. In filtration, we will use only that kind of solution, actually the heterogeneous solution, where we use the filter paper, where the size of the particles is more than the size of the pore of the filter paper, so that the solid is remaining above the filter paper and liquid is separated out into the and collected into the beaker. So with the help of filtration, we cannot separate these solution homogeneous mixture because their size is very small. Because of their size is very small, we cannot see them from our naked eyes. One more important thing, because the size is very small, so that the beam of light, the scattering of light, cannot pass through these particles, right? And we cannot separate these from the process of filtration. We need to use the various techniques, for example the evaporation, and depend on the type of solution, which type of separation technique we will use. For example, for gases we will use the distillation fractional distillation technique we will use for the separation of different gases, right? Next is the, what is the concentration of solution? How will we decide it is a solid, it is a liquid, or a gases? It is actually all depend on the amount of the solute and solvent which is present in your solution. Simply, which amount of solute is present. For example, temperature also affect the concentration of the solution. If I have a glass of water and I start to mix up a sugar solution into it, right? I will dissolve it continuously, not randomly, continuously, and suddenly I increase the temperature. When I increase the temperature, then the dissolving power of the solute molecule become more. It means the solute is more solute is dissolved into the solvent as their capacity of dissolving, right? So in that condition, when I will start to decrease down the temperature, then and cool down our solution, then this kind of solution which I will get is called the saturated solution. Saturated solution means when the amount of solvent, the dissolving power of solvent into the, it means simply you can say that the molecule of solvent dissolve the solute molecule more than their capacity. Solvent molecule does not have capacity to dissolve that how much kind of solute molecule, but due to temperature, due to high temperature, the solute particle dissolve into the solvent above their capacity. That solution is called the saturated solution. When there is no high temperature, it is the very common example you can say that in our home is the chashni, which is a saturated solution in which the water molecule, it means the solvent molecule, have less capacity, but the solvent, due to high temperature, the solvent, more solvent has dissolved into the water, and it make a volatile solution, it make a thick solution, viscous solution, which is called chashni actually. And this is a saturated solution. I will give you example. This is a saturated solution. Unsaturated means when the dissolving power of solvent is less than the saturated solution. Obviously, this is called the unsaturated solution. Means simply at room temperature, in a one glass of water, you dissolve two spoons of sugar or salt, any solute you can use. So this is unsaturated solution. But saturated, when you increase the temperature, the power of dissolving of solvent into solute into the solvent is increases because of temperature. This solution is called the saturated solution. Right, the concentration also obviously depend upon the amount of solute and amount of solution. Find out the concentration by the amount of solute and amount of solvent. It can decide the concentration of the solution. You can also find out, there is various other techniques to find out the concentration of the solution by mass. Firstly, we will take the mass of the solvent and mass of the solute and mass of the solvent. When it multiply it with 100, we will get the percentage of the mass of the solution. Next, by mass and by volume, we will take the mass of the solute and volume of the liquid, because liquid is actually measuring volume, not by mass. So volume of the solvent, when it multiply with 100, we will get the percentage of your solution. So this is all about the concentration and all about the solution actually. Next one important term is the suspension. What is the meaning of suspension? It is also a mixture. This is also a mixture. This is also a mixture, but here the heterogeneous mixture will be there. And in that kind of mixture, there is no mixing of two mixture takes place actually. As the name indicate, only suspension. The mixture are suspended to each other only. The compound which mix to each other, which are suspended to each other, they cannot mix with each other properly, right? So the property of these suspension, because they are not completely mixed with each other, so it means we can separate these type of mixture with the help of technique, the filtration. If they are not mixed with each other, it means their size are large. It means the beam of light can pass easily from these particles, and it is a heterogeneous, always heterogeneous mixture will be there, right? Similarly, one another type of mixture will be there is called a colloidal solution. Here, the more than two type of heterogeneous compounds are mixed with each other. It is also a heterogeneous, but they can mix it in each other. For example, air. Air have various kind of, you can say that the gases are present in the air, but they cannot, you cannot see this is an oxygen molecule, this is a CO2 molecule. We cannot see these gaseous particles simply, right? So that solution is called the colloidal solution, but it is a heterogeneous mixture where the different type of gases are present at different concentration, right? So this is a heterogeneous mixture. And the properties of colloidal solution is what? The size are actually little bit large, so the beam of light can pass through these particles. You know about the Tyndall effect. What is the Tyndall effect? When your room is dark and there is a one hole from where the light is arise, right? When we see these beam of light, we will saw a small particles in this. These small particles are actually the dust particles, which consists the water vapor also, some gases also, and various other substances, because it is a heterogeneous mixture. So this solution is actually called the colloidal solution. So we can find out that we can easily, because we see this solution in the from the naked eye, so it means the size of the colloidal solution particle is large as compared to the solution. Solution substances, solution mixture. So Tyndall effect means the beam of light when it enter into your room from a small hole in a dark room, and we will see a small particle which continuously moving into the beam of light, or into actually it they continuously move into the entire room actually, but because of beam of light we can see these particles. So we can see these particles from the naked eye. So these are the colloidal solutions. Now there are few questions related to the mixture, how these mixture can be separated, and it is also based on your previous knowledge which we actually had discussed in our previous lecture. So first question is, how can we obtain the colored components of dye? Any kind of your blue ink or red ink, any ink, how can you separate these ink from the ink particles, how can you separate these ink particle, these dye particle from the solution? This is a very easy. Take a beaker, fill of water, take a burner also to boiling this water. Over the beaker we will put a watch glass. Watch glass is a glass structure where we actually use for putting the solid substances. So over the beaker we will put a watch glass, and two or three drops, how many drop you want to put over the watch glass, and start heating up the boiling up the water. When we start boiling, then what will happen, ink is a solution where the solute and solvent molecules are present, but they are invisible. It means they are homogeneous mixture, not heterogeneous. So homogeneous mixture can be separated out with the technique is called the evaporation. When the heat up is occurring, then the water which is present into the ink is evaporate out. After the complete water evaporation, we will find that a small particle of blue or red, what kind of dye you had used, blue or red colored particles are remaining over the watch glass. So we can easily separate out the any dye components from with the help of a technique is called the evaporation. Next, how can we separate the cream from the milk? You know that the cream have milk, so that why in the market various kind of toned milk or double toned or without tone, these type of milk are present actually. by the process of centrifugation. What is the meaning of centrifugation? We will use in our home daily. In the milk, we will churn a churning instrument, a churning instrument, which completely centrifugation means which continuously move it out, right? So take a beaker or glass, whatever you want to take it and put a milk into it and start to centrifuge it continuously, and centrifugation means moving machine simply, right? After some time, what we will get two type of density, two particles. The density which the particle which have high density is present at the base, and which have low density over the surface. So water is milk is separated and cream is separated out, because cream have high density, so it is present at the base of your beaker or a glass, and milk is over it. So we can separate out the cream from the milk with the help of a technique, centrifugation. How can we separate the mixture of immiscible liquid? What is the meaning of this immiscible? It means the liquid which are not mixed with each other. It means it is not a homogeneous mixture. For example, the mixture of oil and water, we had discussed it about in the previous lecture, with the help of distillation, right? What we will do, both the liquid have different boiling point. We will start the boil up. Whose density is high, or whose boiling point is less, is separated below, and whose boiling point is high is separated above. So two liquids are separated with the help of, on the basis of their boiling point. How can we obtain different gases from the air? Simple, with the help of fractional distillation. I told you, firstly warm up the mixture of the gases, right? Firstly provide the high pressure. Simply, what will we do into the fractional distillation? At a high pressure, firstly we will make into a vapor. Vapors are formed. Cool down this vapor, then condensate this vapor into the fractional column. When we find out, when we pass these vapor of air into the fractional column, then what will happen? According to the density of the particle, they can be separated out. Higher density, firstly we will get the higher density, lower, 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 and lower. So fractional distillation technique. How can we obtain the pure copper sulfate from the impure sample? How can it obtain? By the process of evaporation. Simply, impure means some substances is mixed into it. We can start to heat up, and copper sulfate is obtained. Pure copper sulfate, simple. So these are the different techniques, and about the different mixture and their properties. For that's all for today's. Thank you.